Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Jason Merrell, and I'm the lead developer here at WebTegrity. And in this week's video, I want to show you guys how to do a child theme from scratch. Now, if you watched last week's video, you know how to do it with a plugin. And plugins are great. I'm not going to be one to diss them. Plugins allow you to do things that you otherwise couldn't because you don't have the time or the know-how to do it from scratch. And there are a lot of plugins out there. And in fact, I'd never seen the plugin that allows you to do a child theme. And it does give you a lot of really robust capabilities that could be a time saver if you didn't know how to do this. The thing is, this is really simple and something that you could do on your own and save your website the workload of having another plugin. And that's what we're going to cover in this video. To do this, all you need is FTP access. Here we're using GoDaddy's FTP access that they allow through a browser, which is really nice. And I've already navigated to the themes folder within our website. And you're also going to need a text editor of some sort. Now, I'd love using Sublime as an example. Sublime is free, it's beautiful, it's very easy to use, and did I mention it was free? It's great for really simple jobs like this, but it doesn't offer the FTP access that you might see in more robust text editors. But it's what we're going to use here, and it's what I recommend for somebody that maybe doesn't have one up until this point. And you can download that. Just go to Google and type in Sublime Text Editor. We're going to be using that to edit the singular file that we need to start our child sheet. So to do this, just to demonstrate how simple it is, we're just going to get into it. You need a folder, and you need to name that folder really whatever you want. Let me shrink my face down here so we can focus on the folder over here. I've named this Sparkling Child because if we look at the theme that Corey's using for WordPress Wednesday, it is titled Sparkling. Now, we don't have to do that. We can name this folder whatever we want. We can name it YOLO Child if we wanted to. And we could still make WordPress recognize that this is the child of the Sparkling theme. But in order to save yourself the trouble, and more importantly, anybody that comes in behind you the trouble of finding what child belongs to what parent, it's best practice just to name it the name of the parent theme. In this case, it's Sparkling, and then Child. Inside of here, we need to put one file, style.css, and that's where this text editor is going to come in handy. I've already named it style.css. In Sublime, you can choose over here in the lower right what the context of your file is going to be. In this case, we've chosen CSS. And we're going to put an open comment, just like that. And then we're going to close it, just so we don't forget. We don't want to forget to close this comment out. And we're going to put a series of designations within this comment block that WordPress actually reads. And some of them are more important than others. First, we're going to start with the theme name. And again, we can name this whatever we want. I could call this theme name Yellow Bob, and it wouldn't be a big deal. But again, help yourself, help people that come behind you. It's just best practice. So we're going to name it Sparkling Child. We can put the theme URI, which is going to be the, I don't know why it's trying to add that semicolon in there, which is going to be the URL of the location of where the theme is, not necessarily where it's implemented, but let's say if you are a developer and you host this theme somewhere, you could put the URL in here somewhere. Again, this isn't terribly necessary. It's just great information to have at the beginning of the style.css. Then we're going to put the description. This is all located inside of the area when you're choosing your themes. So we could be incredibly descriptive and say, this is the child theme of Sparkling parent theme, you know, or it could be silly. My child is going to grow up big and strong. Then we can put the author. And I think it's putting the semicolon because it's contextually CSS and it wants to help me out, but it's not necessary within a comment. We could put the author URI, again, not necessary. Here is the most important part of this entire process within this comment block. This is what WordPress is looking for as far as the parent theme. You need to type template and then type the exact folder name of the parent theme, not just the parent name itself, For example, if 2014 were our parent theme. Yes, that's the name of our parent theme. But that's not going to be what you put here because you want it to be the exact folder name. And when it comes to themes like 2014, their exact folder name is all lowercase and all one word. It would be 2014. Now, this isn't our parent theme. I'm just using this as an example, especially because most people work with these themes and they come across that problem where they type in the exact theme name and they're having issues. It's the name of the folder itself. In our case, it is Sparkling. And then we can put a version number if we want to. So we can put 1.1 if we really wanted to. This is all you need, guys, for your child theme. If I were to save this, let's go ahead and do that. Let's hit File, Save As. Let's navigate. I have it on the desktop. Navigate to that folder that we just created for our child theme, which was Sparkling Child. And if we saved it inside of here, so we're good to go there. Let's go ahead and close that out. And we took this. Also, another good practice. Let me go ahead and get this out of the way now. When you're naming your folders, it's good to go ahead and put that dash in there. Don't leave any spaces. It's just good practice. So we got Sparkling Child. This is our folder that we're going to upload into our themes folder on our website. To do that, let's open up that that GoDaddy browser FTP access that we have. And to kind of show you guys how we arrived at this point, you go to WP-content, you go to your themes folder, and this is what's going to be located inside of your themes folder, all of your themes. You're going to take that folder that you just created and you're going to just drag it right in there. If you're using GoDaddy, if you're using FileZilla or one of those robust text editors, you just copy and paste it in there. And now, see, there it is, Sparkling Child. Now when we go to Manage Themes, which is under Appearance, and then Themes, and we reload this, now we have, I even misspelled it. We have Sparkling Child. It should be called Sparkling Child, but that's irrelevant. It just comes down to that template, that one template code inside of the comment block. We're going to activate this child, and we're going to see a problem right away. Let's go ahead to the front of the website. And I want to walk you guys through this process to kind of explain what everything's doing. If we look at it right now, it's completely without style. That's because that style.css that we uploaded into our child theme folder is completely replacing the style.css sheet of our parent theme. Now there's a couple different ways you could remedy this. You could go to your style.css in your parent theme, copy and paste the whole thing into your new style sheet. But that's not really best practice. If for some reason you update your theme, and the developers of that theme changed style names or added new styles in there, that's not going to be present in your new style sheet because it's only going to have what you copied and pasted to begin with. It just so happens there's a piece of code that you can put that pulls the entire style sheet dynamically, and that's what we're going to add in here. So we're going to go to Appearance, and we're going to go to Editor. And this is going to give us the same access that we would have inside of our text editor. And we're going to put that code that we were just talking about. We're going to hit the at symbol, import URL, open parentheses, single quotation, and we're going to go back one folder, dot dot. We're going to name the folder of our parent theme, which is Sparkling. So we're coming out of our child theme folder, going into the parent theme folder, and saying pull that style.css, pull the whole thing. And then we're going to hit update file. Now I'm going to have all these snippets for you guys in the description, so that'll save you guys some time. But now we're pulling the exact style sheet that we were working with from before. As we can see here, don't mess with me. If it didn't work, that means we didn't call it correctly. So we went back one folder, went to Sparkling, style.css. Maybe we just need to give it a second. Or maybe I need to hug that closer to that. We're going to update that again. Maybe there doesn't need to be a space between URL. We're going to reload that. Now we're pulling it appropriately. So now anything that we pull or put after this, So if we were to, let's say, want to change the name of our, or the background color of our little header area, let's go ahead and grab whatever that container is. It looks like it's navbar. So we could, since we're pulling all of the styles from our parent theme are like they're being loaded dynamically all the way down the page on our new one. But anything we add after that is going to override it. So if we were to go here and do dot navbar and say background color, background, let's use the right property. Background color, make it white. And update that. That's going to override our old style sheet. It should anyway. You got to make sure you're pulling the right class and everything. So here, okay. It wants me to put an important tag on it, but it probably because I'm not pulling it correctly to begin with. Looks like that is the correct syntax he was using before. We're going to do that again. And we're going to hit update, and this should work. So you got to make sure you're using the same way that they're using it in the previous style sheet. And it's working appropriately now. It was navbar.navbar-default. Just an example. You don't need to use important tags. You just need to make sure you're using the same names and in the same way that you are in this original style sheet, and everything works dandy. Any updates that she does now to the sparkling theme will pull in appropriately, and any custom updates that she's done for the purpose of branding this website for WordPress Wednesday will work great. I really hope this helps you guys out. I really hope it helps you understand just how simple this is. And if you have any questions, guys, please put it down in the comment section, and we'll be happy to address it. Thanks, guys, for letting me host this first WordPress Wednesday. It was a pleasure, but I'll see you guys later.